Yes, everyone. Today topic is price difference clearing account. Price difference clearing account. Everyone, please concentrate here. Please concentrate here. Basically, in the SAP, we have two types of prices. One is standard price and one is moving average price. Everyone, please concentrate here. This is very, very important. Sometimes interviewer will ask the question, this process, what is the price difference process? Basically, in the material master, where you can maintain the price, in the material master, at the time of material creation, in the accounts tab, in the material master accounts tab, we are selecting which type of price, maybe standard price or maybe moving average price. There we are maintain the price. Example, per kg, per item, how much price, that price we can maintain in the material master. For example, just imagine, for example, my material is standard price. There I maintain 700. Everyone, are able to follow? Are able to see my screen? Are able to hear my voice properly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Example, in the material master, I maintain my price is 700. Just imagine. But at the time of purchase order posting, I specified price is 600. So in the material master, how much I maintain? 700. At the time of purchase order, go on mute, please. Listen the class, please try to understand. In the material master, I maintain. In the material master, I maintain the price in 700. In the purchase order, I am try to post 600 rupees. If you post purchase order, the accounting entry cannot reflect it. That is the reason, even though if you post purchase order different price, this price difference account cannot reflect it. Please keep it on your mind. If you post purchase order, accounting entry cannot reflect it. That is the reason, if the prices differ with master data, that time price difference account cannot reflected. There is no any changes in the purchase order level. In the goods receipt, concentrate here. In the goods receipt, the price and tax cannot reflected. Please keep it on your mind. In the goods receipt, the price and tax cannot reflected. In the goods receipt, only quantity and total amount can reflected. Whatever amount reflected into the purchase order, same amount reflected into the goods receipt. Then price and tax amount cannot reflected into the goods receipt. Now come to the invoice. In the purchase order, my price is 600. At the time of invoice posting, my price is 1000 rupees. Means here price is increased. At the time of purchase order posting, just for the 600 rupees. At the time of invoice posting, price is suddenly increased 1000 rupees. The total amount is purchase order is 6000 rupees. Sorry, 60,000 rupees. 60,000 rupees. At the time of invoice posting, the total amount is 1 lakh rupees. Price is increased. So the difference is 40,000. So this 40,000, this GL, price difference GL will reflect at debit side. Why? Because if the price is increased, means loss. We are loss. So that loss comes under debit side. This price difference GL reflected in debit side. For example, suddenly my price was decreased. So at the time of purchase order, price is 600. At the time of invoice posting, suddenly price was decreased. Means this 40,000 credit CR, price difference GL comes under credit. That is called income, gain. Basically, as per the purchase order, I want to pay 60,000. But if you post invoice, suddenly price was decreased. Just I want to pay 20,000. Means 40,000 income, gain. So this is called comes under credit side. Price clearing account is credit side. So this price clearing account, everyone, please concentrate here. This price clearing account can reflected automatically based on your prices. The price will be fluctuating based on demand and supply. Price always depending upon demand and supply. Our marketing people will take the decisions. Price or increased or decreased. Okay, so 600 and 400. Example, let's take 1,000 rupees. Increased means this is called debit TR. So based on the price, this price difference clearing account reflected automatically. If this price difference want to reflected automatically, first you want to create this GL account. Where you want to create this GL? You want to create in FS00. And this GL you want to map or assign in OBYC. OBYC. So let's create a GL and map and try to post accounting entries. Everyone, any doubts here?
No, sir.
Yes.
Now no, go sir.
To, yeah. Thank you, everyone. Let's go to SAP. Then open SAP. And enter username and password. Everyone, please concentrate here. So this price difference clearing account comes under current liability. Which under, can anyone repeat? Price difference clearing account comes under
current
liability. Zero balance clearing account comes under current liability. GRIR clearing account comes under current liability. So just keep it on your mind. All clearing accounts comes under current liability. Okay, why? Because this is a clearing accounts.
Okay,
very good. Everyone, go to FS00, press enter button in the keyboard. Then what is your company code? KM10 here, 16 00 and 50, any GL number, 160050. Click on your create. So 1650 already created. Let's take 70. Create. Yes. So 160070. Company code and accounts group. Accounts group. Let's take where is that current liability?
Above.
Current liability. So this current liability comes under balance sheet. And here you can take here. Let's better copy paste this one. Price difference clearing account. Clearing account. Then click on your control data. Everyone, please concentrate here. Line item display, short key 001, create bank interest app, only balance in local currency. Only balance in local currency, line item display, short key 001, create bank interest app, G001, post automatically. You must click on post automatically. Based on the price fluctuation, this price difference account reflected automatically, maybe debit or maybe credit. Okay, if the price is increased, this GL going to debit. This price is decreased, this GL going to credit. Then press enter button in the keyboard and click on your save and back. See this one. So this GL you want to map. Where you want to map? Go to OB. Anyone can repeat? OBYC. The interviewer will ask the question, where do you integrate FI and MM? The answer is OBYC. Why you want to assign the GLs or why you want to map the GL? The all P2P accounting entries reflected automatically. For that purpose, we are mapping the GL here. Okay, go to OBYC. Press enter button in the keyboard. Then here, everyone, go to GBP. Where is that GBP? GBB. Where is that? Page down. Sorry, not GBP. Sorry, yeah. PRL, price difference. PRD. Sorry, everyone.
PRD.
PRD, here, this one. PRD, not GBB. PRD, here. What is this? Price differences, PRD. Okay, you just double click on PRD. Note it down. Double click on PRD and give it your chart of accounts, KMOC, and double click on here and select here. Valuation modifier and valuation class and debit and credit. Why I want to debit and credit? Sometimes this GL may be debit, sometimes this GL may be credit. So you want to click on debit and credit, valuation modifier and valuation class. Then first you just click on your posting keys. Yes. Let's check the posting again. Click on your posting keys. See this one. 83 means debit, 93 means credit. So click on your save and go to accounts. Now here, everyone listen carefully. Valuation modifier means 0001. So this 0001 we are mapped to our plant. And valuation class example 3000. This valuation class we are mapped to material. At the time of material creation, this valuation class is mapped. Then what is my GL account, everyone? 16, just now I created. 1600. 16000. So this is called raw material. 3000 like raw material. Again, 0001 and 7920 16000 00 and 16000 70. 7920 means finished goods. So if you create any finished good material, you want to map 7920. If you create any raw material master data, then you want to map 3000. Okay, then click on your save and back. Note it down. You can note it down this, huh? So in the interview, you want to explain this, how you are going to map, what you want to go into map, how the accounting entry can reflect it, like that, okay? Note it down fast, huh? I give 2 minutes. Done, completed, then click on your save and back. Yes, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Now you just try to post accounting entries. Try to post purchase order, try to post goods receipt, invoice receipt, whatever vendor payment if you want. Okay, let's post purchase order. What is the purchase order T code? ME21N. Go to ME21N. Press enter button in the keyboard. Everyone, please concentrate here. Go to ME21N. It's going on browse. Yeah, now see this one. Let's take the vendor, select your vendor and date, and first you just click on your header. And in the header, select your organizational tab. In the organizational tab, you just take your purchase organization, purchasing group and company code. Now item means 10, then material, then quantity. Example, how much quantity here I taken? 100. My quantity is 100 and kgs. Delivery date, let's take Monday 19th. And click on here. How much rate in the purchase order? 600, right? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Here, my quantity is 100. Net price is 600. So currency INR per one, then material group and plant and storage location. Then press enter button in the keyboard. So in case if you want to calculate the tax, so come down and select here invoice and give the tax code. If you don't want to calculate the tax, then straight away click on your post. Example, let's take calculate the tax plus tax invoice, and here tax code, here items, here invoice and tax code. If you want to calculate the tax, give it your tax code. If you don't want to calculate the tax, don't give the tax code. Directly, you just click on your save. Yes, click on your browse. And click on your input IGST. Now press enter button in the keyboard. So one button will come like this. If you click on your this button, so this is the total amount, 60,000 plus tax, 60,000 plus tax. See this one here, the total amount is 60,000 plus tax, like that. Okay, and go back, and first you just click on your check means in case if it have any errors, it will come. Otherwise, document is okay. First, you just click on your check. See this one? There is no messages. Everything is fine. Then click on your save. It's going on, bros. Please wait some time. See this one. The purchase order number is created. Can anyone note it down this number? Now I want to post goods receipt MyGo. Everyone go to MyGo, MyGo. Press enter button in the keyboard. I don't know, suddenly my system was slow. Anyway, can you please wait? It's going on process, okay? And now go to MyGo and here select here goods receipt, And here, purchase order number. What is the last digit, madam?
It's 489, sir.
489. 489. And give it here plant KMPT. Here you can enter DC. I mean delivery note number. Example DC 000004. And now press enter button in the keyboard. Press enter button in the keyboard. And so everything is updated with reference of purchase order. And come down and here delivery note number 100. I received 100 means in the purchase order 100 quantity. Even I received 100 quantity. Everything is fine. Everything is fine. If it is fine, then click on here item. Okay. Everything is fine. I received 100 quantity. Then press enter button in the keyboard and click on your post or check. Okay, if you post, you can check and post. Check. See this one, document is okay, everything is fine. Then click on your post. So can you please wait some time? It's going on browse. It's picking all the data. See this one. Material document has been posted. So how to see the accounting entry? How to see the accounting entry? See, go up, everyone, go up. In the goods receipt, here you just click on your display and press enter button in the keyboard and go to document info and click on your FI documents. And see this one, everyone. See here, for example, at the time of purchase order, we are calculated tax. This 60,000 plus tax in the purchase order. In the goods receipt, only 60,000 is reflected. Let's see here. The tax amount cannot reflected in the goods received. Price value 600,000 whatever, that price value also cannot reflected in the goods value. In the goods receipt can reflected only quantity in the material document, total amount in the accounting entry. Okay, see this one, raw material account data to GRIR clearing account. Now our target everyone, let's try to understand here. In the purchase order, my price is 600 rupees. Total amount is 6000 plus tax. At the time of invoice posting, suddenly price was increased 1000 rupees. Total amount is 1 lakh rupees. 1 lakh rupees. This 40,000 is loss. I want to pay 1 lakh rupees. 40,000 is difference amount. So this difference amount going to debit. Let's post Myro. M-I-R-O. Myro. Press enter button in the keyboard. And everyone, as usual, document date, posting date, that is common for all, okay? Document date, posting date, and invoice posting. And here, if you want to write the narration, write it being vendor invoice posting. Now, here, everyone, here, select here purchase order. And what is the purchase order number? Anyone? What is the last digit, madam?
489.
Then press enter button in the keyboard. Everyone, let's concentrate here. So how much amount it is showing?
60,000.
So my price was increased, right? My price was increased. I want to take 1 lakh rupees. So everyone, please concentrate here. Here, in this place, in the amount column, here you want to enter 1 lakh rupees. 1 lakh. Press enter button in the keyboard. And click on here, calculate tax. And copy this amount, control C, paste it here. So my target is the remaining difference amount comes under debit side, loss. So press enter button in the keyboard and post. And go to invoice and display.
Sir, document number is stated blocked for payment.
Not like that, madam. Click on your flow of documents. Let's see the accounting entry.
Okay, sir.
See this one. Everyone, see this one. 83 means debit. 83 means debit. This purchase difference clearing account, 40,000 is debit. See, everyone, are able to see my screen? Note it down. Yes, this sir. Accounting entry. Everyone, note it down, this accounting entry. So what, how you want to write? Everyone, concentrate here. This GRIR clearing is debit. This GRIR clearing account is debit. This price difference account is debit. This input GST is debit. And two vendor account. The first line item is the credit and remaining third line items is the debit. So this is the accounting entry I want to show you. Note it down. For example, if price is decreased, so this price difference clearing account comes under credit side.
Credit side.
Okay. Yes.